Here with 5 Eyewitness News reporter Tim Chernow. Tim, you got a tour of a very cool facility today.
This is the kind of stuff I love, and I love sharing it with you. Well, what do they make there? That's the big question. Like special use tools that a doctor might use in surgery or really whatever, because it's part design studio, part factory, part computer lab, all of it in one place.
This is where the ideas get born, and they were joking that the lock on this door is one of the most important pieces of equipment because they can lock all the people who are coming up with the ideas inside so they can keep working and can't get out. Let's go take a look. Here's just one way. Everything here is different. The walls here in the conference room, you can write on them so they can diagram their ideas right there on the wall. Here's one example. I have no idea what it means, but it's probably a really good idea. So let's say somebody says, I want to make a this. Well, they can make it with that. And I want to make a that. Well, they can make it with this machine over here. You're making a device that needs a spring. You pick the spring out over there, and the springs are already here.
Yeah, our philosophy here is have everything here. You just walk down the hall, grab it, and use it.
Someone is working on an idea in there, but they want to advance it. Well, they don't have to start from scratch. You're looking at hundreds of thousands of dollars of donated medical items that they can just modify and skip a step. Not MacGyver, MinGyver. Here in the imaging room is the old way of doing a 3D model of a heart. There is a new way of doing it, a way that saves millions, a way that saves years, a way that will save lives. It's called virtual prototyping, and this isn't a prop. This is a way you can see the future.
What I see in front of me on the screen is the top section, or top slice of the heart that I'm walking through.
And you know what this is? I got you. That's just a printer.
So it's, you developed 3D proprietary software that they were doing with that, and I wish that television would allow you to feel what it, to experience that.
Yeah.
It's an enormous 3D heart that you're like walking through. It's incredible.
Well, it looked like kind of a one-stop wood shop for anything that doctors want, anything they need. They can just go down to these lab rats. They can all sit in an office and think about the next new technologies. Why Minnesota? Why is it here?
You know, University of Minnesota. Minnesota is where the pacemaker was invented. In fact, they said it was the floor below where this lab is. So it's, we have always had a history of that. I didn't know it. There are 400, 500 companies in this state that support the medical device industry. Mm-hmm. So we really are a center point for the whole world. There are people who are coming from as far away as Japan to talk to these people to see what they can do. That's how far we are in Minnesota, ahead of everybody else, and this is just another step in that direction.
Kind of a medical mecca here. Talk a little bit about, for our viewers at home, how is this going to maybe benefit them someday, this think tank?
You know, it's a great question, but one that's hard to answer, because you probably would never hear of the name of the device that they might make. Mm-hmm. It might be a special tool that a doctor would use doing, you know, pediatric heart surgery, where a doctor envisions, if I could only do this, they help them achieve that. You may never see it, but it's there, and they produce a lot of them. Last year, the 8 fellows recorded something like 50 patentable devices.
Wow. It's kind of fun, wasn't it?
Oh.
Did you feel like James Bond in there with all the little gizmos and gadgets?
And they're not even up to speed. They're waiting on some other equipment, but when they're up to speed, they'll be able to do anything. Someone can think it, they'll be able to make it.
Hopefully you'll be able to get another tour.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
I would love that. If you're listening, I'm waiting.
All right. Thanks a lot, Tim. Let's